current state of financial regulation is a little like an impressionist image in a way, because you see some point, but you don't have the very clear full picture at that time.
The FSB's focus since this crisis has been to strengthen the core of the global financial system. And those reforms have focused on four areas: making quality and capital in the banking system stronger, to end too big to fail, to make derivatives markets safer, and to transform shadow banking into a more resilient market-based finance.
In an industry like the banking industry, you'll never have a happy campus everywhere, and you will have to live with some fragmentation and with some unintended consequences, especially when you try to establish a global set of rules.
Something that has been very well done after the crisis, which was to ask banks to have more liquidity. But at the same time, there was also a desire to limit leverage in the financial sector. In fact, the most liquidity you have, the higher leverage you may be. So there also might be some contradiction between rules.
We have done so much over the last 10 years, roughly since 2007, that we should look what is the effectiveness, where do we still have to add regulations, where can we actually abolish regulation.
The objective of all those regulations was to make the financial sector safer, but the ultimate objective is to finance the economy. So in fact, you will assess the outcome, whether we can provide more financial help to the economy.
We also need to make sure that we look at other issues. I would like to really think about how do we treat sovereign debt in banks' balance sheets. Furthermore, we need also to think about culture and ethics in banking. If the ethics and the culture are not right, you're not going to get where you want to go to.
There is a recognition that we need global standards. These are global minimum standards. Without common minimum standards, the system that we have in place today, which everybody benefits from, is not a viable system.